Hey everyone, it's Duncan Epping, yellowbricks.com, and today I'm going to show you what we have done for vSAN file services with regards to a vSAN stretch cluster. As you can see, I already have vSAN enabled, and I've already also created a vSAN stretch cluster, with all of the IP addresses ending in the 30s being part of the preferred fault domain, and all of the IP addresses ending with 40s being part of the secondary fault domain. So what I'm going to do next is I'm going to enable vSAN file services, and of course while I'm enabling vSAN file services, I'm also going to configure the stretch clustering aspect of things. So this is the wizard for enabling vSAN file services. I've already downloaded the OVF, so we're not going to wait for that to finish. And then I'm going to configure some of the file services aspects. I'm going to fill out the file services domain name. So this is basically an internal construct for vSAN file services itself. Then I'm going to fill out the DNS suffix, which is in my case the same as the file service domain name. And then I'm also going to enter the DNS server. The other thing, of course, what I could do is I could integrate vSAN file services with the directory services. I'm not going to do this for this particular exercise, but if you would like to have a level of integration with, for instance, Active Directory, of course, that is also possible. I will select a network to which the virtual machines that are going to be deployed need to be connected to, and of course I need to fill out the subnet mask and the gateway as well. After I've done that, I need to start filling out the IP range for the containers that will host these vSAN file services. These file services could be SMB or NFS. In my case, it's going to be NFS. And then when you fill out these IP addresses, I will do a lookup DNS specifically. So it's going to retrieve the DNS name for these IP addresses. But more importantly, and I think this is something that is crucial, I need to fill out what the affinity site is for each of the IP addresses, so I can specify to which location these IP addresses should belong. And please note, this is a should rule. It's not a must rule. So I'm filling out the affinity for the IP addresses of my file service containers, not for the VMs, for the containers itself. And then what is going to happen is that the virtual machines are going to be provisioned. After the virtual machines have been provisioned, the containers are going to be instantiated. And of course, those containers should align with the location that we specified in this particular wizard. Now, after we've configured everything, of course, we can start creating these file shares. And when you create a file share, you actually have a new option, which basically allows you to specify to which location, to which site, the file share should have affinity to or with. So we're going to go ahead and create a file share, and then we're going to select the affinity that it needs to have. So I'm going to click Add to create a file share. Of course, I'm going to give the file share a name. I could normally select the protocol. In this case, I only have NFS available, so I don't need to select the protocol. And then, of course, I can select a policy. I'm going to make sure that the data is stretched across locations and is protected within each of the locations with the RAID 1 configuration. And then I can set the site affinity, as already mentioned. It's going to get affinity with the preferred location because the VMs that will connect to this particular file share are residing in that preferred location as well. And this will avoid that, you know, whole hairpinning situation where IO is actually going between the two locations across the wire. So we've just created the file share. And after we've created the file share, of course, what we can do as soon as it pops up is look at the details of the file share itself. We can click the file share and then start inspecting it. Now, the interesting part here is, of course, the following. I've specified the affinity site, which is the location to which we will connect to, or through which we will connect. But of course, the data is still being spread across the location because that is what actually was specified within the policy that I signed for this particular vSAN file share. And with that, we've reached the end of the demo. Hopefully, it gave you a good overview of what you're now capable of doing using vSAN file services and a vSAN stretch cluster. Thanks for watching. I hope to see you next time. Make sure to like the video and subscribe to my channel.